I'm John Loyer. I work as the chief economist of Atreides, heading up a team of economic researchers of 7. I'm also affiliated to the Amsterdam School of Economics, Section International Economics. The global economy is growing. However, the growth is negatively affected by a financial turmoil that we saw in spring 2012, in the run-up to the Greek elections. Fortunately, the heads of state, as well as the ECB, took some important steps to address the underlying issues, and that has calmed down financial markets significantly. However, confidence is still low, credit is very much constrained, and government's expenditure is still low. That implies that only very muted growth, if any, is possible in the Eurozone, and we will only see that in the second half of 2013. The Eurozone will stagnate in 2013. That's what we expect at this moment. In the second half of 2013, there will be some growth visible. That picture is dependent on two crucial assumptions. One is that the policy measures that were announced in June 2012 are indeed implemented in a smooth way, and secondly, that financial turmoil does not reoccur. The economies that are expected to do well in 2013 are in the region Asia-Pacific, Latin America, as well as, to a lesser extent, emerging Europe. In Asia-Pacific, there will be significant growth for China, India, Indonesia. In Latin America, there will be significant growth for Chile at something like 4.5%. Brazil, less growth, but still significant, as well as Mexico at about 2 to 3%. In emerging Europe, you'll see growth rates like 2 to 2.5%, for example, for Poland. Outside the usual suspects, I have to say, you can see in sub-Sahara Africa significant growth rates driven by the high oil price. For example, Ghana will grow at 7 to 8%, which is very significant. The economies that are expected to struggle this year will be in the Eurozone. The Eurozone as a whole is expected to stagnate. Specifically, peripheral countries in the Eurozone, those economies will shrink. To mention Greece, Spain, Italy, to a lesser extent Portugal, those economies will shrink. Some muted growth will be visible in a country like Germany, which will grow at something like 1%, as well as other countries like France, but that will be even less a strong, like 0.4% figure. The Netherlands, similar figure. Those countries will grow at a very, very muted, muted pace. Outside the Eurozone, the UK will grow at 1.5% or so. The US will grow at a somewhat higher pace, but also very muted at 1.9 to 2%. So overall, the picture is very low growth. The emerging markets that will attract attention due to their growth potential in 2013 are the usual suspects, I would say. First and foremost, there is China, which will grow at 8%, which is a very high growth figure. China, by the way, is now the second largest economy in the world. In the region, we have also India with 7% growth, Indonesia with 6% growth, and outside Asia-Pacific, there is in the Latin American zone Brazil, which will grow at something like 4%, driven by infrastructural investments related to the Olympics as well as the World Cup. Apart from that, there is Russia, which will grow at approximately 4% due to high oil prices. So, in sum, we'll see a very muted growth in the countries in the Eurozone as well as the United States. But outside the Eurozone, in the emerging markets, growth seemed to be there at very reasonable and exciting growth levels.